Hey everybody, it's that guy here, and this is a let's play of a game that's completely different from every other game that you've probably seen people do let's plays of. Funny story behind it, just briefly. Basically, one of my friends is at work, and I called her up and I said, like, hey, how you doing? And she was like, yeah, fine. And she kind of realized that she had all these ridiculous games come in, which probably would have never sold. And I was like, well, I am looking for a new game to LP, so I'll take one of them. And she was like, really? You really want it? I really don't think you should. But I basically said, like, yeah, I'll buy a copy of it. Now, the funny thing is, like, I'm all for giving games a shot, even if they probably don't really seem like they should have a shot in the first place. But I must say that this is a completely different game from what you're probably expecting. And for lack of better words, I'm only going to do one episode of it. And yeah, I think you just need to watch it and you'll kind of understand. So without further ado, here's the clip. Welcome everybody to Let's Play Delivery Truck Simulator. I'm your host, that guy, and what the hell have I gotten myself into here? Okay, just to let you guys know, I've already tweaked the game so that way it'll turn out as best as possible. There are a lot of settings, but the keyboard, these things don't work half the time. I don't understand why. But the only thing that is worth mentioning here is you can turn your engine off whenever the heck you feel like it, and threading and waving doesn't work. So, yeah, I'm a little disappointed by that, really, because I was hoping to threaten some people. But, yeah. I replayed the game a bit just to get an idea of how the game works, because there is no manual that comes with it, so I've done quite a few stages just to try out a few things, and let's just start at the beginning. Company name is, I just named it that. At first I couldn't fit delivery, so I just said, like, yeah, forget it, just be delivery then. Just be 1 second. Sorry about that, everyone. Had some Christmas pudding I had to attend to. As you can see, I've driven through quite a few four red lights. As well as done some speed limit. It's very easy to overblow the speed limit, but the worst part of the game is it just, if you go, like, because you can only drive at 50 in the area, actually I can't even go to any further areas. For some reason I've only delivered to the same place 5 times in a row. As soon as you tick over to 51, it finds you. No police, no nothing, just find. Same as the red lights. Damage to property. I wish I still had it. Had this to show you guys, but it was basically just my car mounting the curb, and a truck ran into the back of me. The amount of damage that your trucks receive as well is way overboard. I mean, even just driving onto the curb, it has to be an actual raised curb, it does a significant amount of damage. I'm talking, like, you know, 20% damage there. So yeah, really gets carried away. I have to do two more stages and I'll get another vehicle. You can change the characters. For some reason they got continuing back here, so you can actually change how they look. Not that it really makes a difference. He looks pretty serious. And yeah, you can also choose different vehicles to drive. I've just been basically trying to get the most expensive one, and basically it has more capacity to hold stuff, so I've just been taking that everywhere. So I'm going to take the Men DM, and I'll sell the previous one. So yeah, this is after having done, like, 3 stages, and it's still at, like, 95% of fuel, so that's a little stupid when you think about it. I'll just sell that one for now, and I'll show you guys the actual vehicle I got. There's the truck. Basically, yeah, I only bought it in the last mission. You can convert it, but the only thing you can really do is change the gearbox, change the paintwork, which we've got our appropriately ugly colors, and attach advertisements. Now, you don't get to choose what it advertises. Sometimes it's something really stupid, sometimes it's not even in English. It could have done something better. You can buy different depots. I've already upgraded the parking spaces, as well as you can have a repair base as well as a fuel depot there. But the thing is, when you use them, it's not cheaper. It's the same price. You might as well just do it from here. And yeah, if you damage your vehicle, you just click here, and as you saw before, the fuel, you click there. That's pretty much it. You can have different places to start up at, which I guess is the main point of the game, but probably should do that. In fact, I'll buy them now, actually. Just for kicks. Does it open up more jobs? No. Great. So yeah, basically I've only been delivering to the same place, but I think it's because I've actually been choosing route. How's that different? Oh, distance, yeah. I've just been delivering to the same place, it seems. Like, every time I do a stage, it just seems to want the same place to be delivered to it, so... Yeah, but either way, let's get started, just so you guys can see what the heck happens in this game. Pretty much this is the only information screen that you'll see in the game, because otherwise you have to enter the menus and check things out. Sorry about that, I'm just trying some of this crisp pudding, but it's not very good. Yeah, basically, to play this game, you only need the arrow keys. You don't really need a mouse unless the actual view is really bad, which does happen occasionally. And yeah, basically, I don't usually drive in this view, even though it's probably recommended. I drive in this view, and using the mouse, you can look left and right. It's weird though, because it does follow the same ideas as how some games work, which is using keyboard. Can't press multiple buttons at the same time. So basically, if you hold, I'm holding left now, and press hold down, oh, now it is going to work, isn't it? Yeah, that's appropriate. Before it wasn't, strangely. It's like a shiny red man. What's our advertising today? Oh god. Busfahren. Der Umwelt zu lieb. Rheinberger Stratebetrieb. I don't even know if advertising actually did anything for us, but still. Yeah, we're just going to drive around. And just get to the point where we got to... Okay, see how fast I'm going? You want to stop? Open a menu. Instant stopping. You can also cut the engine out if you want. Like, quite literally by pressing the ignition button. This is actually pretty interesting. You can choose to load it automatically, recommended. Or load it manually, in which case you get to use your guy and... It's not really that interesting, really. You just load it like you'd probably expect. Open the doors. See how far away we are? Watch how far the loading ramp goes. That's it. let's just close that. I don't think you actually need to close it, but still. I guess you could drive... Oh, actually, no. You can't get in a vehicle unless you've actually done that, so... Yeah. Okay. I'm pressing the T button to threaten, but it's not working. I want to threaten someone. Okay. So, let's just change the view. Okay. The way to get out is actually here. It actually took me a little while to figure out, because I couldn't see it half the time. And not to mention, there's no tarmac, driveway, anything that would suggest that it is the right way to go. Okay. Now, let's get on track. Okay, just remember, you're supposed to drive on the right side of the road. I'm just going to drive on this side of the road. You're supposed to get a fine for it, but obviously not. And I'm just going to try to... I'll just show you guys what I said about the speed, okay? So, in the bottom left, it's our speedo. Oh, I'm not getting fined. Oh, that's right. Has to be... nearly crashed. Instant stop. Once you hit... 55, sorry, you have to be 5Ks over the speed limit, then it counts it. But normally you do get fined for driving through the red light, but if you do this... yeah, it doesn't make any sense. What I was talking about with driving over the curb, it's not quite a curb per se that I was referring to. It's basically like, 50 euros. See, I don't understand red light thing considers it, but you know how like plants sometimes have that raised, oh there you go, in the background there, those little ditches there around the plants, which kind of keep the water in, those actually can damage your car extremely badly. I actually got bogged on it, because Actually, to be honest, I don't even know why I got bogged. So, it's weird. Yeah, you can just basically speed through, and I've gone the wrong way. Doesn't matter. I'll take a right turn here. Oh. Yeah. There we go. Not bad. Not bad driving for a freak playing this game. I mean, I gotta admit, what can you possibly say about this game? Now, the thing is, this is actually in a line of other games which are simulation-based. Now, I haven't played in any of the other ones. This is the first one. It was based... Me getting this was based solely from one of my friends actually saying, like, oh, who's going to buy that? And I was like, I'll buy it. But now she's kind of angry with me because it means that she's going to get more stock in of this because she'll probably be, like, the only store that's actually sold a copy of it. And now what's she going to do with it? So... Probably shouldn't have bought it, huh? Ends up being more trouble than it's worth. There we are. I was thinking, like, we're off the map. Yeah. Being a delivery truck driver, is it fun? Probably not. Not if you drive like this. Yeah, we could probably amp the speed up a bit as well. A little bit. Not that we can really go that fast. Oh, it doesn't matter. Oh. And... cheating. Yeah. Handbrake. You can't actually do handbrake turns. The only time you can apply the handbrake is when you actually already stopped, so... yeah. How is this for very bad housing? Very bad office placement. There you go. Warehouse is right there. I'm sorry if you guys can actually see the cursor, but the strange thing is this game isn't really Fraps compatible, so the cursor has to be set to on in Fraps, which I don't know how that's going to work out. So, but at the same time, if I don't have the cursor on in Fraps, I can't see it in this game, which doesn't make any sense really. And there we go. There's a mission done. What the hell? maybe you guys probably should get this game because it's just so... what the heck? I mean, how do you explain this to someone? Like, what have you been doing all weekend? I've been playing a delivery truck simulator. So they kind of just stare at you and then they punch you in the crotch or something like that. The funny thing is, like, it's got all these different ways to set them out, but why would you even bother? You just take the one that's like gives you the most money, wouldn't you? It makes more sense. I mean, you can't accept jobs which you don't have the right vehicle for, so... what do you know? It's the same place. Kind of weird though, because I was thinking maybe you could, change. Does it really matter? Not really. Yeah. Let's just do one more just to show you guys what the heck. It seems stupid, but you know. But at the same time, I gotta admit, like, I always feel like giving pretty much every game a shot. Assuming I don't have a single idea what the hell this game is about, like, I'm all for that. It's not a bad idea per se, because, like, you know, just, it's something different. And, you know, you're probably used to playing, like, you know, your CODs or your, Halos or Assassin's Creed, and games like that, but at the same time, you're just so used to playing the same stuff, maybe you should go out there and, you know, try something a little bit different. It's kind of like going and playing sports, I guess. For that matter, I used to be really good at sports, but now I am shocking at it. So, oh, yeah. How to stop instantly? Automatic. I really can't be bothered. Throw that pile of stuff in, and there we go. I'm pretty sure you don't actually put pallets of stock in this kind of vehicle. Like, it doesn't really make much sense. So, okay. Again, watching for the speed limit. I just like to give myself a little bit of a buffer zone. So, yeah, even though I can go up to 55, I really want to drive up to here. So, And one strange thing I found out recently is that my headphones were only recording at like 30% of maximum for some reason. I have no idea why they were set like that, because I distinctly remember setting them to 100%. But instead they're at... Oh crap! No, don't hit me! Oh! who cares? We got heaps of money. sorry. by the way, this is because it's European. It's red, yellow, green, and then yellow, red again. So, yeah. But by the time the yellow, when it goes red, yellow, green, by the time the yellow shows up, there's no time to react. Like you haven't even sped past it anyway. So, because your acceleration is that slow. But it looks like I'm a little. Little heavy around, so I'm not going to be able to drive as fast as I like anymore and take turns like a psycho, because apparently I can go in two wheels and tip myself over. So this delivery is only going to be worth $5,000 now. that's pretty bad. Man. At least they considered it. I mean, I'm glad that they even thought of that in the first place. It's like, how can you explain that to people? Alright, let's... Oh no, it's gonna happen again, isn't it? I better do that. Okay. Just, what, two more turns, and that's it? I guess traveling that fast is a bit excessive, though. Wait, what are we, 50k or something? Which is actually not that fast. I find it amusing enough that it takes that long to reach 50k an hour when, you know, it should only be, well, not that bloody long in the first place. So, okay, and beep, 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 beep. Here's your damn pallets that you wanted. Take them. They're yours. Now we're out of here. Wait, it actually gave us like $7,000 then. So did it? Oh, it didn't take the money from us. So new vehicles available. Just as bad as the previous ones, I'm guessing. No, these are huge trucks. But it costs so much. Gee, but if I sell the current vehicle. 55% damage. That's a lot. Oh, well, yeah, if we sell that vehicle, of course we're going to make it now. Oh, this game is suddenly so addictive to me. Maybe I should keep playing. I'll do one more, actually. Only because I got a new vehicle, so... Yeah, let's see. What can we do? Oh, that's what I want to see. And it's the same damn place again, but because I've changed my location on my vehicle, yeah, that'll change everything overall. What can you say, huh? About this game. But for this company, I understand that this game has actually been out for quite a while, so... And apparently it's also not its first game from this series either, for that matter. So it is quite possible that they have really cleaned up their act and changed games around and stuff like that. Oh crap, because this is a new area, I don't actually know where the loading zone is. Or it could just be in the exact same spot. Let's find out. Oh, I need to go a bit more forward. Okay. Let's go. Oh, it makes the beeping sound as well. Alright. I'm a real truckie now. I mean... what? That's not how you put pallets in a truck. How do we get out of this damn place now? I can't see the gate. Gotta find the gate. Gotta find the gate. Gotta find the gate. No, don't wanna park. Where's the gate? Ah, oh, there it is. Okay. Away we go. Oh, maybe we should go the other way, huh? No, it's okay. Stop, I said. Oops. Okay, looks like we'll have to go around then. What? What's the speed limit here? 30k? Why is it only 30k? Oh, I think this is their way of saying, like, this is a new map by choosing this depot. So, okay. Or maybe it's in this vehicle. Actually, it could just be a vehicle. So, but still 30k is pretty slow. Like, you're basically driving around a parking lot or something. Yeah, I'm all for giving games a shot, just seeing how they are and seeing what they're like. Because, I mean, you know, when you first start up in the world, obviously, you're not going to know exactly what you should do, what's the best. I mean, it is possible for you to, you know, kind of choose games you're used to, but, you know, if you're going to make another shooter, I think that people will just be like, it's the same, what's the point? Let's have the map. I'll get across there, okay. Oh man, am I going to make it in time to even... Oh god, I'm not going to, am I? Let's just do it quick. But like, yeah, it... I look at games on the shelves, and I get very easily intrigued by games, because sometimes they can actually be quite good, and other times they're just absolute garbage, but you never really know until you try. And, you know, you just want to give it a shot at least, so... this vehicle is very slow. Oh crap. I did not upgrade the... No, I did upgrade it. But then again, the speed limit is still really low anyway, so it doesn't make a difference. So... Again, what the heck compelled you to play this game? Is it because I'm trying to mess with a friend that's, basically, she sold me the game, and now she's probably going to get more in stock because of it. Is it because I like being a delivery truck driver, even though I don't actually work as one? Oh god, we're actually entering a new area, so it's going to build them. Or is it the fact that that I'm an idiot? I don't really care about games. I'm just doing whatever I can. It's like all the LPs I've done so far. Someone said that they were all weird. I don't mind that, in case you're wondering, but they're all games that I'm familiar with. Well, except for this one, obviously. But pretty soon I'll be doing one of a game I'm not familiar with, actually, which is Zelda 2. I'm going to take this pretty slowly because not that I can really take it much slower than that. Zelda 2, because I'm not really familiar with Zelda 2 on the NES. From what I understand, though, it's a very long game, though, and the worst part is most people don't know what they're going to do for the game, so I'm probably going to have to use a walkthrough for it to play the game, because I've seen some people play games, and you just have no idea what to do in it, and I got to admit, yeah, that would tick me off. I'm not going to make hundreds of videos of me just getting lost, because... Firstly, I'm sure that you guys don't want to watch that. If you guys are going to watch videos on this, then I can understand if you want to watch like actual footage of stuff being done in the game, rather than someone just getting frustrated and screwing up in the game, which is something completely different. But, well, what can I say, huh? Ugh. Alrighty. Yeah, that marks the end of that stage, and, well, let's just see if anything's really changed at all. Nope. This is supposed to be like what you can do, but it's just garbage. That's very upgraded. That's upgraded. Could have at least attached an advertisement. And yeah, so pretty much everything's the same. It's kind of ridiculous, really, because. Oh, we can collect stuff as well! I should probably do that, huh? Just to try it out. 1.7k's. Delivery, transport. That's only for 1,000, whereas you could get 10 grand. Okay, anyway, I'm going to finish this video here because this is just getting stupid now. I do hope that you guys enjoyed watching this. I had a lot of fun playing it, which is kind of weird, you wouldn't expect it. But yeah, I do hope that you enjoyed watching, and well, take care of yourselves out there, yeah?